Subscribe to our YouTube channel and click the bell icon.
The first aspect on which I'd like to share a few of my thoughts is on the use of technology in courts. In my view, I think courts and judiciary as an institution has adopted and used technology far more than other institutions have in the present pandemic. Many of the high courts are conducting their hearings through video conference facilities, and so is the Supreme Court. And of course, a few national tribunals have also jumped onto the bandwagon and are conducting proceedings through video conference facilities. But in my view, the one thing that is really lacking is the absence of a uniform protocol all over the country on how e-courts must function in the form of video conference hearings for contentious matters. I think it is only desirable and it would be appropriate that the Supreme Court of India lays down a particular set of standards that are to be adopted during video conference sessions by all courts in the country. And laying down these standards will help on two counts. One, it will certainly lay down a particular minimum threshold that one expects to achieve during video conference sessions for courts. And second, it will bring about a sense of uniformity across the various courts in the country, making sure therefore that lawyers are more equipped and over a period of time gain more familiarity on how the platform should be used. I don't think that the Supreme Court should limit video conferencing facilities to a particular platform, and that's really not desirable. But what is desirable is to have a set of standards laid down, and any platform which actually complies with those standards can be used. Now, we've had our set of troubles by using video as the base platform in the Supreme Court, whereas some other high courts have done well by using Microsoft Teams or Google Meet or even Zoom at various points of time as the platform. But all said and done, I think as a council, our courts have been extremely efficient in adopting and using technology to make sure that there is a continuous process of justice dispensation during the pandemic. I think the way our courts function in this country is bound to change and change permanently. COVID-19 will of course come back in multiple versions and mutations in the future. Social distancing will become the norm, and therefore how our courts function will necessarily change. Yes, we as lawyers thrive in a court system, the court ecosystem, the questions from the bench, the interjections from the other end of the bar, the battle of wits, etc. But crowded courts cannot be the norm. It cannot be that all of us are in court in the morning for a mentioning, or one senior counsel is assisted by 15 junior advocates. I think that's bound to change. We should necessarily use video conferencing to aid regular court hearings as well, and not just do court hearings in video conference during the pandemic. And we have to allocate specific time for hearings like most Western jurisdictions do. And therefore, unless we as lawyers learn the art of brevity in terms of our argument and decongest our courts by using technology, we are bound to have problems in the future. And therefore, unfortunately, lawyering as we know it and the ecosystem in which we thrive will change. My advice to younger lawyers as to what they can do during the lockdown period, you know, I think this is in some form a blessing in disguise. No lawyer gets 4 or 5 weeks of undisrupted time to read. Like for COVID, testing is a mantra. I think for a lawyer, for success, reading is a mantra. My only advice therefore to younger lawyers is pick up anything that you can find on the law and read, whether it is an authority in terms of a text, whether it is a bare act, whether it is just some judicial decisions that you can lay your hands on. A simple reading of the bare act multiple times actually gives you a different perspective. Read the bare act to understand what it is. Read the bare act thereafter to critique it. Don't just read the words in the statute. Please look at the gaps. Let's remember, like musicians, we lawyers also must identify the gaps. Music is not made by simply the notations of music. It is also made by the gaps within those notations. Similarly, the architecture of a statute should be understood from the gaps in the statute also, as compared to what is written in the statute. So the simple mantra is go continue, read as much as you can during this time. And of course, on a personal note, I think again, as lawyers, we never get time with our families. I think God in some form has given us 4 or 6 weeks with our families. Make the best of it. Make sure that you enjoy yourselves. And then let's all be back in court soon, back into the ecosystem that we thrive in.